Let's talk about electric energy and power. Suppose if a wire is there, a conductor is there, the current is passing from A to B. We know that the direction of the current is always from higher potential to lower potential. So immediately one can write VA is greater than VB. This is the first, at first instance you must observe this fact. Now what is the potential energy? Potential energy is nothing but, we know that U, the potential energy, we have derived Q times the potential at that particular point. So now if I write UA Q times VA, let's consider the small delta Q charge is passing through. Then UB is equal to delta Q times VB. Now the change in potential energy, suppose I wanted to get delta U. How do I do this one? The potential energy final minus P initial, that is U at B, let me write the suffix, minus U at A. So this I can write it as delta Q times of VB minus VA. So UB means delta Q times of VB minus UA means delta Q times of VA, and I took the common. Now from the definition of the current, delta Q by delta T is only I. So I can write I delta T VB minus VA. But as VA is greater from this step, it is negative. So less than zero. So potential energy is, if I consider that this difference is V, then minus I V delta T. So we calculated the potential energy difference when the current is passing through a conductor. So far, so good. Now, according to law of conservation of energy, initially if you take that the electron or any particle or charged particle is at rest, then total initial energy of the that particle is zero. Therefore I can write immediately the value of kinetic energy is same but with positive, so that when I add these two I must get zero. I hope you understand this logic. But we know that the electrons will not be accelerated when the current is passing through the conductor. They will be moving with a constant drift speed. Therefore, the kinetic energy is zero. Then the question arises, where this kinetic energy has gone? Or is it violating the law of conservation of energy? It's not violating the law of conservation of energy. Why actually the electrons are not accelerated? Because of the collisions between the atoms and electrons. If any electron is hitting an atom, it bounces back with the same velocity, but its kinetic energy is transferred to this atom. Then atoms are initially they are vibrating. Now the magnitude of that vibrations or the amplitude of the vibrations is increased. So when the vibrations are increased, the kinetic energy is released in the form of heat. So this whole kinetic energy, that is IV delta T, is nothing but released in the form of heat, or you can say that it is electrical energy. So we got the answer for the first. What is it? Electric energy. Now what is power? To calculate power, we know that power is equal to energy by time. The rate of doing work, the rate of energy supplied is only known as power. So energy, we got IV delta T and time delta T. Therefore, the power is the product of current times potential difference. Now I can replace this V according to Ohm's law as IR. So I can write I times IR. So that is I square R. This is another formula for power. And now I can also write with the help of Ohm's law I is equal to V by R. In that case, V times V will be there in the numerator and R is in the denominator. So these are the three different formulae for power. Now, suppose if you have a power station here and the power is to be transmitted through wires to a village, then certainly these cables, because they are very long in terms of kilometers length, they will have larger resistance. Let the resistance be RC, connecting wires or cables, RC. This is the power station and this the resistance of the cables, and I is the current passing through this one. Then in that case, the power dissipated through the cable is I square RC. This I can be written as P by V, because we know that power is equal to I times V. Just now we have derived. So this square RC must be PC. So this is PC. Now, how to minimize this PC? This we wanted to reduce. So to reduce that, this power is constant, the power stations. And once we install the cables, you cannot change the resistance. What we can change is the voltage. So it is, if you keep the higher voltage, then this becomes automatically lesser. But keeping the higher voltage at the other end, at the destination's end, or at the village's end or city's end, is highly dangerous. Then how to solve this problem? So this problem can be solved with the help of a device called transformer. The details of transformer we will be learning in the chapter alternating current. But just to transformer is a device which maintains the power input and power output same, and it can alter the current so that if it increases the current, the voltage remains, dropped. If it can reduce the current, so that voltage can be increased. So transformer is capable of increasing or decreasing the voltages at the cost of increasing or decreasing the current. So by using this apparatus, this loss can be minimized. That is the reason why the advantage of AC, or rather AC is much more cheaper than the direct current. Anyway, we will talk about all these topics in the chapter Alternating Current.